because if you look at the INEC was established as it were to organize the elections, supervise the election, but even beyond that, promote knowledge of sound democratic process. And now, when election happens and people die, their dependents, what do they do? Oh, we just talk about it and nothing happens. Let's assume that after an election and people died or people were molested or people were assaulted, and then their dependents, they go to court and then they begin to hold federal government, INEC, and even the state government, whoever is responsible, accountable for what happened. Because, of course, like I said, the federal government owes a duty to us to provide an enabling environment. So if there was no enabling environment and somebody died or somebody was assaulted or somebody was molested, federal government is responsible. So we should go to court. For instance, I know that recently in a case in Omotosha and IGP, it was held that a man and woman with their children, they were on the road driving in their car, and of course normal Nigerian thing, police demanded for money, they did not give, and the police shot the man. I know the man died, and the wife and the children, they went to court. You know what was for the court to determine was whether what happened was a violation of human rights. And the court held that the man's right to life was violated. That's number one. Number two, that's even the one that is interesting to me. They said that for the policeman to have killed the man in front of the wife and children, that violated their own right to dignity. That is one thing I think Nigerians, we need to begin to look at the laws. We need to look at the constitution. You see, for instance, if somebody dies during election, that's violation of right to life. If somebody is molested and assaulted, that's violation of right to dignity. So what are we doing? Let's go to court. Let's hold INEC responsible. Let's go hold federal government responsible. Let's hold state government responsible. And even beyond that, we can go to ECOWAS court.
The thing is, speaking about going to court, a lot of people, average Nigerians, are very afraid when you say let's take this thing to court. It feels like, okay, fine, I don't have the money to pay the lawyers, and it will drag for a long time.
There are lots of NGOs
let me tell you
going to court free of charge for people.
No, it's not all of them.
There are lots of them.
Okay, let me tell you a story that happened. A woman, let me just say, the person is a lawyer. He beats the woman black and blue because the woman doesn't have anybody to help her out. Then the woman was not afraid of going to court or call police. I don't know if you are getting me, because she said that she doesn't have money. Now somebody now said, okay, I'm going to help you to go out there, and so you'll be able to tell them what this man has been doing to you. The woman said, okay. Do you know that the woman went to the police station to report them? By the time she have gone there, the man has gone to the police station and paid them. You see that kind of thing? And gave them money. Now, this thing happened in Enugu here. It's not far.
Real?
Yes. The story is still on. So now the woman went to the police station, told them, look. So they now said, we are going to come and arrest the man in the morning. So she told them that he always stays in the house from 8 o'clock. Do you know that 12 o'clock, a police people will say, madam, we have gone to that place now. We did not see him.
For real?
Yes. Now, just imagine the kind of injustice in the country, even in the state. Now an NGO person that went there to ask some certain question, ask please what exactly is that, okay, I will go with two people there in the morning, I will come here around 7:30 so that all of us will be able to go there in the morning. Do you know that they keep delaying? When she went there, they keep delaying until it was 10 o'clock.
Then now, the time the man has gone.
Yes, and the woman was telling them, this man don't usually come here, he don't stay in the house by 10 a.m. Let's go by that time. So it was later, one, the way they used to talk. So she just said, madam, I think you need to go and the rest. So this case has been settled. Imagine this kind of thing. So sometimes you look at what is happening. Is it not violence against human rights? And the woman, then I told the woman to take it to court. The woman doesn't have the money to take it to the court. Yeah. The NGO woman said that she doesn't even have money to support her.
Incidentally, there is violence against persons prohibition law in Enugu State, and it's working. There's also a commission based on that law. So the person could actually go to the commission and complain. You see, some of these things is just about knowledge. I think we should...
But how do we get people to know their rights? It starts from there, actually.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. It is like what you're doing, like what I'm doing. Like, and I think that's what I, for me, I think one of the ways to get out of wherever it is, the woods we are in this country, is that we need a massive training, and we're training on human rights for everybody. For everybody. Everyone
even people to know like, their rights. When a police person comes to arrest you, you'll be able to know your rights and tell her, this is my right and you are violating my rights. I don't know if you are getting me, because these people think that people don't a lot of, for instance, now like you just said, people don't know their rights. Because if people know their rights, there are things you will come and tell me now. I will tell you, no, I cannot do this thing. This is my right or this is not my right. You understand what I'm saying? But people now are busy. People are busy moving. Whatever that comes to them, they just take it that, like that. Because they don't know their right. That is why people will come out and arrest someone for no... Even when you don't do anything, and you don't even know your right, it's very bad. And this is the thing that is... It's one of the things that is causing violence.
The truth is, I think there's something, there's some sort of a power behind the uniform. So when people wear the uniform, let's not even go too far into the police force. I've seen this MOT people in Enugu here. You know, they're the regular people, but you know, when they wear their uniform, it seems like there's sort of power,
an extra
that
power
that envelops
Karl Marx
them.
Says, power intoxicates, absolute power intoxicates, absolutely.
Well, I think, what do you think, Barrister Judah, the force in every strata and cadre should have a training of its personnel, because they are also brutalizing Nigerians.
Yes.
And it's terrible.
Apparently, you cannot overemphasize that. The truth is, we need to train and keep retraining, but remember that they keep employing and they keep employing. I don't know if you get my point.
Yeah.
That's why we should train and retrain. But then let us not forget to report. If we keep reporting, if we keep making noise about some of these things, if we keep speaking
that's
out,
true.
You see, whether we like it
how,
or we like
how
it.
Can someone go to police station, a woman that was violated, that went to police station, they now told her that she will bring petition fee or whatever, 10,000 naira. Someone, a victim that came to you and said, look at me, so what are you helping?
Okay, Gemma, when she told you, what did you do?
When she told me about the case,
yes,
I picked up, we are working on the case. Now, even I will meet them this morning.
You see, for me, let me say this on air.